Hey guys, it's Natalie Nunn, and I am most known for being on the Bad Girls Club. Everybody remembers me because I was the one who was notorious for being the naughtiest bad girl.
Mind the hair, baby. Just put the hair up. There you go.
I took them off.
Woo! This is what I do, baby.
That's it.
It's time to have fun.
Yay! What is it like?
Yay!
That's more.
Yes, it is.
That's more. I'm going to eat chicken.
Big brother, you got me in a house with some real bad bitches. Like, what's up? London! I'm going to tell you who I'm not really f***ing with right off top. Kirstie, like, you're not the president. You're not running in this house, period. But see, I'm a bigger up. She thought she was running. I was like, let me open the door for you. Let me walk you up the steps. Kirstie, let me show you. In the morning, you know, I'm finna be like, get your ass up and get out this room. What you doing up in here? Like, what is happening? It's cool. But you know who's supposed to be in that room, right? Like, hold on, let me fix my crown. Girl, don't get comfortable.
Why? So, basically there was like, a shoot that was booked through my agency, and it turned out to be a setup. So I ended up getting kidnapped, held for 6 days. And yeah, that was my bad experience. So I left my agency after that.
6 fucking days?
Six
where?
6 days, in Milan.
Is that where the shoot was?
That's where the shoot was, and then I got, they drove for like hours to like North Italy, and that's where I was held.
But did anything happen to you?
No, it didn't hurt me, which was good.
Were you traumatized in any other ways? Like,
basically, I mean, like, but he made it out to me that it was a massive organization, that he wanted to save me, but he couldn't because there were so many people behind it. And that's what was scaring me, because I thought, there's like so many people behind this and I have to pay the money, otherwise I'm gonna die.
Oh, so they wanted money?
Yeah, they wanted 300 grand. And I was like, I cannot pay that at the moment. So they wanted it from my mum, from my agent. They were trying to get it. But this guy that's now been sentenced, he was always telling me that he was on my side, but he just can't release me because of this organization. I just had to think, what can I do to survive? And that's what I had to do, just to make him like me so that he would release me. And that was my only focus, to just think, this guy's got to like me in order to release me, because I know he's on
did
my
you
side,
have to do,
but
like,
he can't.
Other things?
I didn't do anything sexual, no.
Really?
But I had to, that's what the thing was. I had to like promise him things for the future. And then when I was doing that, I saw that his reaction to that was like really positive. And that's how I kind of went about it.
Okay.
And then after me thinking the whole time that it was a massive organization, it turns out to be two brothers. And they tell me it was like hundreds and thousands of people.
Were they cute?
Cute. Fucking ugly fucks.
Like, was it a kidnapping or was it like a...
No.
Okay. Like, you remember
their
faces
forever? But that's what
forever?
I had to do.
Like, do you remember their, like, crazy faces forever?
Yeah, that's how I was able to identify
the
other guy.
Sorry. That's, like, that's traumatizing.
Yeah, but at least I know that both of the people involved are now in jail, so it's just all right.
I don't think anyone wants to know, should want to know anyone's storm. If you do, then...
Really? I want to know who I'm living with. Absolutely. Well, I want to know what... I would like to know things about people.
Then you should...
I don't live in the UK, so I don't know what your guys'
Then you should ask them individually, I think.
I have asked individually, and I'm asking again, Ryan. I have the right to ask what I want to ask.
You're asking me.
No, I asked the room, sweetheart. I asked the room.
But I'm in a room full of other people.
Hold on, wait a minute. You just said you don't want to know, but some people might want to know. And I'm me, Natalie Nunn. I'm asking, though. I'm just... Because we're all sitting here.
A group of people.
And we were gonna talk. You guys don't live in America. You guys are not in Hollywood. I don't know you guys. It's not that big of a deal. Why is it so like tense and everything? Like, is your storm that bad? Then I really want to know. It's like, Jesus Christ, relax, guys.
It's just not easy for some people to talk about it sometimes.
That's fine, then say that. Not, oh, we just don't want to talk about it. Playboy, I want to know who I'm living with. It shouldn't be that big of a deal to talk about it. How many documentaries have you done?
Natalie, but you're
just
saying...
Just answer me a question.
I have,
how many TV shows have you done?
I've done about nine television shows.
Excuse me, 1 second.
19 television shows.
19?
18 documentaries.
18?
And six reality shows.
And have you had a problem talking about any of your storms?
No, I talk.
He spoke about it in here. He spoke about it in here already.
No. But I was asking again.
You're here and you keep saying America. I know you're from America and you're proud. And that's
yeah,
great.
And I don't know half of you guys here.
And we don't know you before here.
And that's fine.
And that's why we're all getting to know each other.
But if you get to know each other, Dan, please, with all due respect, getting to know each other by playing with fruit all day and bowling things. Listen, sweetheart, I would like to know who you guys are because I'm living in this house with you. Mm-hmm. I'm sleeping next to you. I'm showering with you guys. I have a husband. I would like to know who the f*** is married, who the f*** isn't married, why you don't have a ring on, why you, I would like to know. I want to know who I'm living with. Absolutely. Well, I want to know what, I would like to know things about people.
If people don't want to say it.
I didn't force anybody to just say it.
Stop shouting.
It's so negative, man. It's just ridiculous.
Wait a minute, time out. Negative? I've actually came into this house and was introduced to Dan as he was single. And then 5 seconds later, Gabby comes running in and says, he has a wife, he's married. Like, okay, so time out.
I'm just giving you an example.
Yeah, cool. I am being told one thing about certain people, another thing about someone. Chloe sat up today and didn't even know that Jermaine had a girlfriend. We don't even know what the fuck is going on. Do you think I care?
Get over
because
it.
Because he said something about the work.
Get over it. I talked to her already, so I thought that the air was already cleared. She came here to talk to me, and then she apologized, and then I...
I didn't get an apology.
Well...
She's a... Period. She's a... And there's a little bit of hate, a little bit of anger. A little mad. Maybe thinks it's competition. I don't compete with anybody.
No, darling.
I understand that this is a show and everybody wants to win, but I'm not competing with anybody in particular.
No.
Just having fun. If you want to conduct the thing, I would have just.
She does something.
It's funny that you got an apology, but I didn't.
You sat on the vanity chair soaking wet. I can't like move the vanity chair and put another one there. So I'm stuck sitting in the seat I always sit in and it's dripping wet.
You don't have to sit in
the window.
That's where I sit. That's where I do my makeup. No, I'm not. Because then I have to move all my somewhere else and make a mess and not clean it up like you guys are doing? Don't sit in the chair is what I told you to do. Don't sit in the chair dripping wet. It's common sense. That was insane. It's actually rude.
Oh, it's not like they're wet every day.
Terrible.
But it doesn't matter. Why didn't you just put a towel down and sit there?
It's not hard to move your makeup.
Why didn't you just put a towel down? It's common sense.
Oh, I forgot one time. Sorry.
Oh, you forgot. It's not that hard to forget to put a towel down when you're dripping wet. It's like common sense.
I wasn't dripping wet. I might have wet clothes.
You were wet. Your bed was dripping wet.
It won't happen again. It won't happen again.
She's only young.
It won't happen again.
Baby.
She's just a baby.
Don't come over here, Rodrigo. Don't come over here, buddy.
It's true.
No, Rodrigo, shut up.
But don't we have...
Because you were in the vanity room talking about her doing the same thing.
No, I agree that she shouldn't say it.
Because you want me to say it. You're like, you say it to them. You were the one in the vanity room talking about the meat leaving the mess.
I wasn't.
Then you want me to be the bad guy to say it.
No, but I agree.
Shut up, Rodrigo. Shut up.
It's not mine or yours.
You just sat there and said in the vanity room.
And then
you are a piece of work.
But
right
then
now.
When
you are a
and
piece
then,
of
and
work.
Then I said, she's
you
just...
are a piece of work, making me say it, and you were the one complaining about it. You are a piece of work.
Chloe, what I said.
Oh my God.
And then I repeat. I said.
You are insane.
Chloe's just. Chloe's just young.
I'm not cleaning up after fucking nobody in that goddamn place. I took her hair extensions and threw them over on her side of the vanity. Cause they're like spread out on, this is not, she's like, sit somewhere else. Bitch, this is my fucking seat. I'm finna sit where the fuck I wanna sit. Like, bitch, why don't you get out the bed and go sleep in the bed with Jermaine?
Right.
What is she here to do? She's here to be promiscuous. She's a page 3 girl. She shows her tits, she shows her ass. Do that then. What other career do you have?
3, 2, 1.
Celebrity Big Brother house, this is Emma. Hardeep.
show.
Natalie.
Hi.
The viewers have been voting all week. I can now reveal the first housemate to be evicted from the Celebrity Big Brother house is...
Natalie Nunn has been evicted from the Celebrity Big Brother house. Natalie left taboos from the live audience, telling Emma she was overwhelmed. Natalie and Hardeep received the most nominations when housemates voted for the first Natalie. Time earlier this week.
Natalie, stay exactly where you are. You will be leaving the house shortly.
I did not see that coming.
Fuck. Damn.
Wow.
Celebrity Big Brother house, this is Emma. Natalie. It's time to leave the Celebrity Big Brother house. I'm coming to get you.
Wow. 30 seconds!
Wow. Be careful, honey. We can't leave the
room. Oh, smash it, darling.
Oh, bye, Natalie.
Bye, Natalie.
Smash
bye,
it,
bye.
20 seconds! Jesus
Christ. What they time?
And we'll see you soon.
Head up, girl.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Are you kidding me? I left over all of these fake people in the house. This is insane. Sally, you were supposed to be like a medium, a psychic, whatever you call it. You predicted it was not gonna be me. How am I gone? Sally, you told me, you were like, oh, you have nothing to worry about. You're gonna be here till the final. Okay? Like, it's hard to be an outspoken, strong woman. I get it. There's a lot of things that you guys haven't seen with me and the real Natalie, and I feel like almost played. I came in blindsided. I didn't know any of these people. I didn't Google any of these people. I didn't know anything about anybody in this country. I just came in as an American, loud, strong woman, and owning anything I did. I was a bad girl, okay? I'm gonna own it. And I'm out before them? This is insane. It's crazy to believe that I really have been evicted. First of all, I've never had an eviction notice on my door ever in my life. It's actually embarrassing that I've been evicted out of the Big Brother house. I thought I was gonna win. I'm still gonna wear the crown because it's like, honey, I always win. Who? The show's over, I won. Like, you know, it's insane. I really don't know what happened. I'm sorry, the UK, I let you guys down. I'm just an outspoken woman. I can be loud, but I also can be quiet at times, sometimes. And I call it how I see it. I call it how I see it. And unfortunately, I've been evicted. I'm really sad. I'm devastated. I thought I can actually really bring the storm to the house. You're gonna definitely have sunshine with everyone else. And I came with the hurricane and the storm. I thought you guys wanted that. Evidently you didn't. I'm out first. What a joke. It's really upsetting that I can't just live out loud. Like, it's time to live out loud. It's 2018, you guys. Live out loud.